episode 2166, Just Because You Can.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. It is a brand new week, and that means it's Mindset Monday. Are you ready to impact the world that you touch? Yes, you have a few weeks left in the year of 2020. So go out and give what you have been gifted with. Just because you can. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already didn't have the opportunity, you want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You are here for such a time as this. Don't run from what startles you. Embrace the fears of the unknown just because you can. This is the reason for the season. You matter. You may wish for something different in your life, but how are you living it? Wishing is different from living. We can hope and wish upon a star, but your actions reveal that which matters most to you. When has impossible ever stopped you? I'm sure there were times when you stumbled upon caves of fear. It was so dark and you were so uncomfortable that you decided to stay right where you were. Then there were those weeds that tried to add some cushiness so you were not so quick to run. It was like kind of hidden comfort. You might get a little itchy, a little uneasy, but you still stayed put. The thing is, you still had this fire deep within you. There was something that kept nudging you, something deeper than what you control of your own self. Sometimes we're given dreams. I truly believe this. We are given direction by God. And sometimes we don't like that direction because it makes us uncomfortable. We think we're not equipped. We're not ready. We have too much to do. We go down the list and say, well, Lord, I can't do this because I have to have this, 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 and this. And this whole list shows you things and reasons why you can't do something, and you begin to cling to that. If you aren't wrestling with what God is asking of you, maybe then it's not really worth chasing. At the worst possible moment, the greatest opportunity can arise. You can let your excuses bury you, or you can let fear ignite you. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Let fear ignite you. You may let your fear and facts that only you see guide your actions. Just because you can hang out with fear and get comfortable with where you are doesn't mean you should. Let fear ignite you just because you can. You know, life may dish out inconveniences, interruptions, and inconsistencies. In fact, that's what a lot of people are saying about the year of 2020. Maybe 2020 was actually good to you. Maybe it was another year. Maybe it was another season in your life. But instead of grabbing hold of the negative of all the stuff, grab hold of the blessings of the positive hidden within that negative. The uncertainty is only what you are not willing to explore. So let fear ignite you and let the passion of your doubts lead you. And they're not just any doubts. These are doubts that can change your life. It can change the direction of the way you go. It can take you from one path to another. So what does that look like? These doubts, D-O-U-B-T-S. Number one, identify your dreams. What are your dreams? And I'm not talking about those dreams that are so far off, like for me now, becoming an Olympic ice skater. Yeah, I don't think it's going to happen. I'm not talking about those kind of dreams. Now, way back when, that dream was real. And it could have happened. It didn't for lots of circumstances that came into play. But back then, yes, but now, no. That's a far off, like, no, it's not going to happen. So I'm not talking about those weird, far off Jack and the Beanstalk dreams. No, we're not going there. I'm talking about your dreams, your passion, your calling. And you're saying, I know that this is what I'm supposed to do. I don't know what it looks like, but I can't escape it. It's deep within my belly. It's buried within my heart. It's attached to me. And when I talk about it, it excites me. Identify your dreams. Number two, identify your obstacles. What gets in the way? You know, because you don't fear anything you don't know. Seriously. Because then you can set yourself up for an expectation of, okay, wait, if this comes along, then I will be prepared this way. So if you're one who wants to go and travel the jungles, I don't know that I want to go, but let's just use that as an example because that's pretty kind of far out there. But I know there are people who have those dreams. And if you're one who says, I don't really like snakes. Okay, if you're in the jungle, you're probably going to come across some snakes. Well, what do you think you're going to do to prepare for those snakes that you may encounter, which are probably very highly likely that you will encounter them? You're going to study as to what to do. You're going to learn about the snakes in the area that you're going to go to. You're going to learn which ones are poisonous. You're going to learn which ones, okay, you just don't touch and mess with. Then there are going to be others that you're like, okay, come hell or high water, I'm taking that snake out because it's going to kill me. And so I don't mess around, right? So you set yourself up to where you are prepared. So when you go out, it's not unexpected. You begin to anticipate it. So then you can prepare for it. Now, does that mean that you're not scared? Oh, no, I didn't say you're not going to be scared. I just said the fear is not going to be as great because you're going to be prepared. So identify your obstacles. What's getting in the way? And you can't use your children. I'm just saying. And you can't use your spouse either. Now, some may say, but I have to consider that. That's true. That would be a season of life. I would not say they're an obstacle. It's a season of life that you're in. So think about that. Don't think of them as obstacles. It's very, oh, you got to be careful on that one. Number three, identify your uniquenesses. You are one of a kind. You matter to this world. You're going to touch the world that no one else can with your gifts and your talents. So what are those uniquenesses? Are you one that can get on a microphone and have a conversation every single day with people and be in their ears? Maybe, maybe not. Maybe you're one who has a compassionate heart for children and you just want to be able to go out and help them and serve them in whatever capacity that you see. Identify your uniquenesses. Number four, identify your buts. Just like obstacles, we have buts. Oh, I'm willing to do that, but... And those buts are big. And sometimes those are the ones that we cling to the most. Because we're like, ah, if I cling to this, I already know kind of what it is. I'm going to stay comfortable here. And then guess what? I don't have to go reach out to the unknown. I don't really want to go there. So I'm just going to stick with the buts. No, identify them. So then you can't run from them. So identify your dreams, your obstacles, your uniquenesses, your buts, and number five, identify your truths. What's real? The truth. Not what you think is, not just what you see, but the truth and what God has given you, how He's equipped you, maybe how you have walked with Him and what you see and the patterns in your life. And you can begin to see the unfolding of things. Identify your truths. And finally, number six, identify your strengths. Where are your strengths in your everyday? Where are your strengths in the seasons of discomfort, in the seasons of pain, in the seasons of hopelessness? What are those strengths? Notice I'm not at all mentioning your weaknesses because we get hung up on those. You want to work off your strengths. You notice the obstacles and the buts are wrapped around what? Your gifts and your talents, your dreams, your uniquenesses, your truths, and your strengths. That can't be taken away from you. And what it helps you to do It allows you to take your passion, your calling, and this fear that you have, it just allows you to ignite it. Because why? You're holding on to the right doubts. In order to step out into the bigger picture, God's plan for you, your fears cannot rule your days. No more fears, no more excuses, no more self-sabotage. Only doubts that reveal your blessings. They're the best doubts that you can have. Your dreams, your obstacles. What makes you you? Your uniquenesses. What keeps getting in your way? The buts. What are the truths that God has revealed to you in your heart? And some people say, well, Christiane, I don't know about that particular one. Then ask others, trusted people in your life. Ones that you go to when you need guidance. And if not, I'm happy to talk to you about it. But what are those truths? And then what are the strengths? It's your doubts. I know a lot of us lead our lives with doubts, and it's all the negative stuff. We allow ourselves to get down. We hold on to the hurt and the pain. And we let that serve a purpose for our anger, for our outrage, for our outbreaks, for just being willing to be crabby. Oh, I just want to be crabby because I just feel like being crabby. You don't know what I've been through. No, I may not know the details. God does. But you see, God also says that I'm going to take what was meant for bad and have it be meant for good in your life. Now, will it show up the way you think you should see it? I can't guarantee that because I'm not God. I don't have the picture of how he's leading your life. But what I do believe is that if you begin to take a different look, a different page out of the book that God has written versus what you were writing, it's going to change the course of your life. I don't know where you stand right now. I don't know where you're suffering. But I want you to know that you are loved and that you are truly heard in the good times, the bad times, and the ugly times. And it's not just about, okay, give me what I want. Yeah, God sees that. But he sees more. He sees your heart. And so on this special day, in this season, just because you can, I want you to dream the heavenly dreams, the heavenly calling that God has on your life. I want you to soar on wings like eagles. I don't want you to sit here and continue to belittle yourself. Maybe you had a rough weekend. Maybe you had a fight with your spouse. Maybe things just aren't great with your kiddos. And you're like, and now I've got Christmas holiday coming up. And what's that going to look like? My house is going to be crazy. You know what? Take a deep breath because God's already got you. Sometimes we have to realize that we can't do life on our own. That we're better together. And that together is with other people who are wanting to uplift each other, who are wanting to pray for each other, and then including God in your everyday. You see, God just doesn't show up during devotion time for you. He's there when you're pumping gas. He's there when you're making dinner. He's there even when you're fighting with your spouse. He's there when you're in the bathroom by yourself, tears rolling down your face. God's got you. So don't allow your mind to wander. Don't let it go into the caves of fear. Don't hunker down. Instead, let fear ignite you to well up within you the passion and the calling that God has placed on your life. take the doubts and lean in. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Just because you can, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a blessed day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.